Hey, I'm Lee Padgett. I'm a product manager here at Takeuchi. The intent of this video is to explain the exhaust aftertreatment systems on the Takeuchi TL series track loaders and to demonstrate the regeneration process. Before we look specifically at the regeneration or regen process, it is important to understand the function of the components used in the Takeuchi exhaust aftertreatment system. In order to keep exhaust emissions to a minimum, all Takeuchi track loaders have a diesel oxidation catalyst, or DOC, a diesel particulate filter, or DPF, and on models over 74 horsepower, a selective catalyst reduction, or SCR. The DOC acts similarly to the catalytic converter in a car, converting carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons into carbon dioxide and water. The DPF removes soot or particulate matter from the exhaust system, while the SCR on machines over 74 horsepower uses diesel exhaust fluid, or DEF, to reduce NOx emissions. As soot accumulates inside the DPF, the machine uses a process called regeneration to raise exhaust temperatures and burn off the soot inside the filter. Under normal working conditions, the default mode for the loader performs the regen function automatically. In this setting, the operator doesn't have to do anything and normal machine operation can continue without interruption. If the operator is using the machine in an area that could have potential fire hazard, this function can be disabled using the inhibit switch located inside the cab. Note, if the machine is turned off and restarted, it will default into the automatic regen mode. During times of extended idling, low operating temperatures, or minimal engine load, the machine may require a manual or parked regen. The operator will receive both visual and audible alerts indicating that a parked regen is necessary. Initially, there will be a flashing regen request and an engine fault lamp and a beep every 10 seconds. The frequency of the alert will increase if a manual regen request is ignored and not performed immediately. To perform a manual regen, first find a safe, well-ventilated area to park the machine. Ensure the engine coolant is at operating temperature and there is sufficient fuel in the tank. Next, raise the lap bar and lower the engine speed to idle. Then press and hold the regen command switch for approximately 10 seconds until you hear a single beep and the regen prompt indicator lamp comes on. At this point, the exhaust temperature warning indicator should come on, the engine speed will increase and decrease as the manual regen takes place. This procedure generally lasts 20 to 45 minutes, but could be longer depending on the level of soot accumulation. Once regen is complete, engine speed returns to normal and the alerts on the screen will turn off. Now what happens if you don't perform a manual regen right away? The soot load is going to accumulate at an increased rate, which will cause the machine to enter into a limp-home mode. This will be indicated by the flashing regen request, an engine fault lamp, and an audible buzzer that sounds at 1 second intervals. An engine error code will also be shown and recorded in the monitor's vehicle error code display. When this happens, engine speed and power will be reduced up to 50%, which will require an authorized Takeuchi service center to perform the maintenance. If the alerts can't be cleared using these steps, or if you're getting frequent regen requests, call your Takeuchi service center right away. Remember that proper machine operation and maintenance are key to being productive and safe. Follow the guidelines detailed in the operator's manual, which supersedes any information presented in this video. Thank you, and we hope that these tips will help you maximize the uptime of your Takeuchi track loader.